Well, hello, hello, hello. It's time. It is time. The bell of the Kingdom Age rings for you. And Christ is calling each one of us by our own name. Will we answer? I will. Will you? Good question. Love from love, hope from hope, peace from peace. It's time. It is time. All things shall be restored. The Lord said many things which I have to say to you. There are many things, but you can't bear them now. He told his apostles before he left, howbeit the Spirit of truth, whom I shall send unto you from above, shall guide you into all truth. In the future, the truth that he would send in the future through his messenger of Malachi 3:1 to bring forth the perfect preparation of his peace, his kingdom age peace, of his kingdom age covenant brought forth through the everlasting gospel with the everlasting covenant of Jeremiah 31. And he said he would send it from above, and in the future it would guide all of mankind into all truth and bring all things to everyone's remembrance, whatever he has said to mankind. And after my departure, he said, there will arise the ignorant and the crafty, and many things they shall ascribe unto me that I never spoke. Beloved, the Kingdom Age Covenant is Christianity, but it was changed, and the words, but you gotta believe, were added to the Word of God. Here is God's covenant, beloved. I am the messenger of Malachi 3:1, the covenant message, new covenant messenger. The Lord God says, I will be your God. You will be my people. I will forgive all of your iniquity, sending Satan to the pit for 1,000 years. And I will write my law and my love on your heart. And beyond that, no one will ever need to be taught of me. The least, from the least of all people to the greatest, shall all know me. So what happened? Well, the Word of God was changed. And just as Jesus said in the Word, many things they ascribed unto him that he never spoke. They made him, transformed him into a God of condemnation, who had judgment and wrath upon everyone, when his voice was always love and forgiveness only. And many things which I spoke will they withhold. He prophesied of people that would change his word. But the day will come and have, when the clouds shall be rolled away, and the Son of love, the Son of righteousness, the Son of truth shall shine forth with healing under my wings, says the Lord. For I am the way, the truth, the life, and the doctrine which I teach is that which I am. I am it, and it is I, Christ. Not me, I'm just Daniel. I'm just his messenger. No one's ever going to accuse me of saying I'm anything special. I know what I am. I'm the alcoholic of Habakkuk 2, King James. There are so many things written that Jesus did that if they could all be written, I suppose that the world itself could not contain the books that should be written. Well, I've been writing a few. And know that in dreams and visions of the night, when deep sleep falls upon men, then doth all the wise open their ears and send, as God sends them instructions. If we are wise, we will know. All I know is that if the world is good without the sun, and if the world is good, man without eyes, and the soul without understanding, then it is good not to know anything about anything that I'm saying. But unto those desiring the good things, the Lord says, I am the true bread and the living vine. The fathers of God's chosen children did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is, within this video, is food of God. And you are as gods. John 10. The first are last, and you shall be first. So eat therefore the food that cometh down from heaven in the latter days, just as it is written in Daniel 12:9. For mine word was only closed until the time of the end. And whosoever eats of my living word shall not die. For I bring the living food, and I am the living bread, which is now coming down from heaven. I stand above all mankind. The great white cloud of Matthew 24 and Revelation 14, same cloud, is before all men. Multitudes and multitudes are in the valley of decision. And if any eat of the food that I bring upon the great latter-day mountain of Micah 4:4, they shall have all their shame and guilt removed from them upon that mountain of the banquet of Isaiah 25, as it is promised. This then is the marriage supper of the Lamb for all who wants to live forever and keep their love alive. Time for passion, time for glory, time for burning. And it is time that mine servants, my olive trees, bring forth these videos as leaves that will heal the nations, as I give my truth. And the living wine which I now offer is my life, my love, through my chosen alcoholic Daniel. One who is transgressed by wine, Habakkuk 2, King James, and one whose eyes are dull and red of wine, but the just shall live by his faith. And when Shiloh comes, Genesis 49:12, look it up. The scepter of all of my authority has gone unto him, because he restores all my truth. So happy are those following my way, but unhappy are those despising wisdom. So it's time, people. It's time to reverse the curse. So praise the Lord. Let's gear up. Let's do it. I'm willing. Are you? Are you willing to put on the buckle? Buckle up. Because we can blast off anytime anybody wants. So praise the Lord. So here it is. Here's the deal. Are you ready? I dare everybody to read the very best Passion of Christ ever written. 24 hours it took me to record it. From starting at Palm Sunday until the resurrection. 24 hours to record it. And I dare everybody to read it because See, I'm a writer and I'm used to talking about reading. But, you know, this vision was for the appointed time at the end. And God said, "And it shall surely come. Behold, his soul is not upright, but the just shall live by his faith, even though he's transgressed by wine." And he said, "Their vision is written plainly on the tablet, so all that heareth my servant of Isaiah 49's voice, mine arrow that I carry as the great white horseman to conquer the red, the pale, the black horse. All is before you, and all is unfolding. So know that our rock of the ages walked the greatest walk while talking the purest talk that ever could have been talked." So get ready, people. It's time. Good evening. Time for the blessing of Enigma. Because the mystery of God is over. The puzzle of the ages is finished. The Enigma is no more. It's obsolete. Hebrews 8. If only people would believe the utter gospel truth, it would make my job a lot easier. So it's time to praise the Lord through all of our misunderstandings, our righteousnesses as filthy rags, our understandings. His ways have been so much higher than ours. So receive if you have hands. And if you don't have hands, we'll call you stubby. The world of truth, the world of love, the world of progress, the world of moving beyond, the world of the kingdom age just ahead of us. Take a deep, deep breath. Let go of all that you've known. It's time to gear up for truth. Truth and nothing but truth. So help me, God. Let the revelation begin. Revelation of revelation. So welcome to the climax, to the great fireworks of all the prophets, the culmination of everything that has been prophesied. For it can never be denied that our exalted architect of the foundation of the age of grace, which is now over, even divided mankind's calendar asunder, for it was always his job alone to split time in two. Even those who don't believe in our Lord of life know that he made a much bigger impact on our world than the largest meteor that has ever hit. Therefore, the legacy of Jesus has survived throughout the darkest ages while setting some of the darkest souls free by his most radiant light of love that has always been unconditional and veiled. So it's therefore a story with no past tense, for it still speaks very loudly of future days of utter bliss that shall pound our earth's ground with the fury of some very peaceful divine tranquility and serenity on steroids. And it was his passion alone that set the temple for all of creation to sing their heart out with gladness over his long-awaited return. And his word has returned, as Daniel 12:9 foretold, through his kingdom age covenant messenger of Malachi 3:1, the latter-day Daniel of Daniel 12:13. As a result, this is both the beginning and the end of his story, but he is the Alpha and the Omega, and he is coming back to his temple in Jerusalem as the book of Malachi, the prophet, foretold. So it's time that we should all be looking back at a blood-soaked history revealing its most incredible climax, and it is greater than any fireworks that have ever exploded. And nor does it matter what anybody thinks about Jesus, for it shall come to pass that every soul shall bow at his name of love. For those who love are born of God and know God, because God is love. 1 John 4:7, that is his name, capital L-O-V-E. And every tongue shall confess, and every knee shall bow all over the world. For those who love are born of God and know God because he is love. So praise God, for every soul looking towards his glory shall never again be able to stand in his shadow, because his blinding light will not allow any shadows to be, since his overflowing brightness shall never again allow any kind of darkness. And that man from Galilee could find faith in a pile of unmentionable. And so shall it be that it's time for the confetti to fall. And it's time for the Jubilee of Jubilees. It's time for the great celebration. Because he can find faith even in a pile of hopelessness, much easier than any disease could ever find the spirit of death. And nor was there ever any doubts that he would also be able to find some very deep trust in the deepest seas of doubt. For only Yeshua HaMashiach, Isa, Yeshua Jesus, could make down to become up, fear to become faith, all while transforming darkness into the most brilliant light imaginable. Even the heavens declared that he was a diamond in the midst of sand and gold in the middle of ore. For the most holy name of that Lion and Lamb of God is precious. That is his name. Neither should any of us ever forget that this eagle and dove of the Most High waits for all of his own upon the most wondrous winds of the most wonderful wonder that he has prepared. I cannot imagine or see. Thoughts cannot imagine what he has done. While he patiently calls all of our names as if we were the only one. So we should never forget that he abides in us, his light of love. And let not your light go out. That is the unforgivable sin, blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. If we let our light go out, we perish evermore, because we need his light of love for our everlasting bodies. For all of creation has been groaning for the revelation of who is the sons and daughters of God. The word of God says this, beloved, of things to come concerning the future of my sons and daughters and the work of my hands. Isaiah 45, command ye me, I did. The next thing I knew, I was writing by a light for 7 minutes that was never plugged in, way far away. So, beloved, the Lord lit my light, and he's still doing it right to this day. Literally, he's giving me a miracle the last 9 days, 10 days, I'm losing track. Every night I've got a broken light. It's been coming on by itself and going off all day long. And it's not solar. That's the thing. But he abides in us so we can hide in him. So take a journey, please, through the most amazing amazements ever recorded. Hear the passion of Christ. Let all believers in Isa Yeshua, Jesus Christ, now celebrate, for the time is coming when the Lord will be cleansing house as he brings forth his harvest. Even now, one like Moses has come. Deuteronomy 18:18. I am the leader of another great exodus, the great exodus of the great falling away. But it's never been about the bad leaving the good. No, it's been about the good leaving the bad. It's been about the wheat leaving the tares. The wheat are the spiritual people that will believe in the spirit of prophecy. The people that believe in not judging one another. The people of love who are open-minded, open-hearted. They must leave the religious, closed-minded, anal-retentive, shallow as a glass of water people that will never unite in love with one another. So let all people of obedient pray for his everlasting gospel's global success, for the everlasting gospel you are hearing. But I hope you're not just hearing it. Listen, and it must go again to all people, to all tribes, to all nations, because people have never understood his everlasting covenant. For he says, now I will be your God, you will be my people. Oh my God, if you understood. He said, and I will forgive all your iniquity and never remember it. There shall be no judgment day, people, or he's a liar. And as those supplications of all the obedient go heavenward, let us all be thankful for the hard times which has put us through the Lord's purification by his hottest refiner's fire. Even now, the trial of all flesh, COVID, comes forth to bring his word of patience, to keep us from the hour of the temptation to ignore him. From heaven, his heavens are thundering away as his messenger gives his message of love for all men. So let all men now be fearless in the pursuit of that which sets their souls aflame. It's no more for the walking dead, for the passionless, for those dead to life. Listen now, O searchers for love's absolute truth. The most important day in anyone's life is not the day of their birth. It's the day when they find out why they were born. That's the blessed time when they'll finally discover that only Jesus Christ alone brings forth redemption and eternal life under the glory of God's seventh heaven. My God, people. Oh. So it's time, and I'm going to flip this around. People, I've been going like 10 men creating a bunch of videos nobody's watching, and so shall it be for some time. I'm being ignored. People hoping this false prophet will just go away, but I'm just gearing up because the Lord is lighting my fire. You ain't heard nothing yet. I promise you, if he has one breath left in me, I am the most compulsive and obsessive character you could ever possibly meet when it comes to my beloved love of the ages, who is the Radiant One. He is the Majesty of Majesty, Hero of Heroes, Icon of Icons. He is Emmanuel. He is our Carpenter of the Ages, and he is roaring from Jerusalem louder than ever before. Will anyone hear that? Anyone? I hope. Wait till you hear the burning bush. It's up next, you know. You want to climb it? Oh, beloved, beloved, beloved. I should have been dead many, many, many years ago. My sister Cheryl, who's in glory, she found me with a bag of glue glued to my face. I was passed out. And then the Lord lit my candle, and he's changed this alcoholic into a controlled one. Every 3 days, 7 drinks. This is one of my whiskey nights. And all translators of the Word of God in Habakkuk 2, they all expunged and removed the true prophecy of an alcoholic. Yeah, even though he's transgressed by wine, the just will live by his faith. Who could get anything from an alcoholic? Nobody that's ignorant to me. True story, because by default, you're standing in line with Morgue Official, the revealed lawless one of Revelation 13:13, who would die by a sword because he's a sword swallower. And then all the world would wonder after the beast who was, is, and is again once he comes back. And then he would be the Antichrist. But praise God, that future has been cut short exactly as Malachi 4:6 foretold and exactly as Matthew 24:22 foretold. For our Lord God is faithful to perform his own word. He breathed on me, people. You can ignore me, and you can ignore the truth, but it's going to get shinier and brighter every time I preach, because I'm getting better at preaching. I've never preached a day in my life. I'm the hidden arrow of Isaiah 49, and when you get me going, Christ shall be the victor through me, and his glory shall cover this earth through me, as waters covering the seas, grass covering the lands, sands covering the deserts, snow covering Antarctica, 1 mile deep, white on rice time.